Now, Philippine factory gate prices slightly up in March. The producer price index rose to 97.5 last month from the 97.2 in February. This meant a growth of just 0.3%, although this slows the decline that began in February. The Statistics Bureau says this was mainly due to improved manufacture of coke and refined petroleum products. It adds the annual rate of the manufacture of computer, electronic, and optical products help improve producer prices. The Bloomberry Resort sells 921 million shares to its subsidiaries Ceres Properties. The special block sale of about 16 billion pesos is part of a settlement by Enrique Razon's company with Global Gaming Philippines. Bloom says with a sale of shares, the settlement deal is now complete. It was ordered in 2019 by a Singaporean arbitration court to pay up $300 million to GGAM, which accused Bloom of booting it out of the management of Solaire Resorts and Casino in 2013. Next to the Consuni Group, which lays out its plan to revitalize Cemex Philippines, its largest investment to date, the DMCI says it would focus on increasing Cemex output, reduce its costs, and integrate it further within the group once its multi-billion dollar takeover is complete. The cement giant had reported 2 billion pesos in losses in 2023 on the back of higher costs and reduced sales volumes. And finally, Bank of Commerce launches today the public offer of its peso bond issuance worth 5 billion pesos. The San Miguel affiliate lender says this is the second tranche of its 20 billion peso bond program. Public offer runs until May 9th and will be listed on the PDEX on the 16th. Bancom says the proceeds will be used to refinance maturing debt obligations. Meralco Chairman and CEO Manny Pangilinan says the power provider must boost its capacity to keep up with a surge in demand. During Meralco's briefing Monday, Pangilinan addressed reports of recent overloading incidents in Meralco's service areas. He said the government and the private sector must also work together to find solutions to the country's thinning reserves, adding the private sector is willing to invest.
Logically, if there's more capacities available, then we should be able to address substantially what might happen, black swan events like this, no? Although this could become a permanent feature because of climate change, diba? So we should be ready for that. Meralco's got to take a look at this distribution network, diba? And start building more capacities to accommodate surges that we're seeing now. Because if it happens again next year, or the, siyempre, question kami ng media, by the government, what are you doing to make your network more robust?
A group of delivery riders urging the Marcos administration to address the high commission being taken from them by delivery platforms. The Coalition of Couriers and Shipping Services says they have reached out to government agencies and the Philippine Congress regarding the issue, but no action has been taken so far. The group, along with the Lala Move Drivers Association, will hold a nationwide strike tomorrow on Labor Day to protest this matter.
May shipping fee ka ng 100, delivery fee, halimbawa po 100 pesos, 20 pesos po yung kanila, 20% po. Sana 10% na lang sir yung kanila eh. Nananawagan na po kami, halos 1 year na po eh. Tapos sabi po ng DICT, aayusin daw po at ipapatawag. Pero hanggang ngayon sir, mag-iisang taon na, wala pa rin eh.